Some days ago, I was speaking with a client and trying to help them walk through a variety of business issues. And as is often the case, phrase came out, or the sentiment, be an aspirin, not a vitamin. Solve a pain. And so we began to work through this thing for him with some things that he was toying with offering. And the first question that I asked was, what pain are you going to remove? And that sparked some questions, and we began to work this thing through. And so I thought that I would just give you a simple framework here in this little video of being aspirin and not a vitamin. Now, the thought process is nothing terribly new. It's America does take a lot of vitamins. I assume people in most civilized cultures take vitamins. Wasn't always the case. However, aspirin consumption vastly outweighs vitamin consumption. We want something to eliminate pain. We're far more willing and ready and able to invest in those things that will eliminate pain or reduce pain than we are in those things that might prevent it. So here's the framework. The question, the beginning, has to be a focus on that pain. What pain can you remove? Whatever your business is, whatever your offer is going to be, what pain can you remove? And you need to find an audience with big pain. Now, there's a bunch of little side corollaries to this. It obviously helps for you to have a full understanding of that pain. Copywriters, especially world-class copywriters, for decades have said that it's not so much in the ability to write the copy as it is the ability to really understand the pain of the market. When a copywriter can get behind the eyes of the target audience and fully understand the problems that they've got, the challenges that they face, and the pain that they feel, then the copy that flows can be that much more compelling. People can write wonderful, well-written copy, but if they don't have a full understanding of the pain point, it's not much going to matter. So what pain can you remove that leads to finding an audience that has big pain, and the corollary or the auxiliary point here would be pain that you have a strong awareness of. So that leads then to the next step, and that is to describe in detail a profile of your ideal prospect. Who are these people? And it's not only who they are in demographic terms, it's who they are in every possible way that you can find that out. That also directs us then to where. Where do you find these people? Where are these people? And in today's world, a really specific question is, where are they online? Where do they hang out? What websites do they visit? What search terms do they plug into their search engine? Those are all really important things to know, because in this online world, which has so dramatically shrunk the world, we need to connect with them, and we need to connect with them where they are. I realize there's a lot of time and effort and money spent in search engine optimization and all kinds of ways to drive traffic to you. And as great and as wonderful all that is, it's really difficult. I mean, it's really difficult. Throw your shingle out there. You can say, well, I've got this thing that I can do to remove pain. I know an audience. I know who this ideal prospect is. I see where they are online, but no matter, I'm going to build my own online presence and I'll just attract them. It doesn't work that way. It's much easier. It's much better to connect with them where they are. Go where they're at. Engage with them. Connect with them right where they are. You're not going to have great success in trying to attract people to your web real estate unless or until you can connect with them where they are. And you got to give them value. Now, my specific is you got to give them value, and you've got to give them value for free. You've got to give them value without any qualms, without any expectation, just simply to serve. You hear it, people talk about it, and the reason they do is because it's true. It's difficult for some people because they want to immediately map out this revenue stream and get all of the business ideas down cold. And this isn't as linear a process as that. I'm not saying, in fact, I would advise you to think about what you can sell, to think about what you can do, to think about the price points that you can have. But first, you've got to get this whole cycle to the point of where you're connecting with people where they are. If you fail to do that, frankly, nothing else matters. And the only way that I know to do that is to start at the beginning, work your way around to connecting with them where they are. And at that point, you can begin to provide as much free stuff as you can. And then you can get your toe in the water and you can start testing things. You can start seeing if there are people in this crowd that will pay you for something. And they either will or they won't. And at that point, you can now begin to kind of test and see some things. Excuse me. But it really boils down to pain and the elimination of pain. And where do you fit in all that? If you don't have the ability to eliminate pain, you're going to have a real difficult time serving any kind of a market. It's just how it's going to go. So think about being aspirin, not a vitamin, what pain you can remove, and find an audience that has big pain. Keep in mind, I didn't say find a big audience that has pain. Find an audience that has big pain. Doesn't matter necessarily how large or how small. Well, yeah, it does to a degree. I mean, there could be something that the niche is so narrow, and that niche is one that maybe they even have pain, but they're fully willing to live with it. Don't try to push that boulder up a hill. Find an audience that has big pain that would love to have that pain removed. And that pain, by the way, can just be some difficulty. It can be some gap in the market. It can be some area where, there's a little bit of a gap in the solution. There's a little bit of a gap in the pain management. But by and large, you're going to be better off not reinventing the wheel. You're going to be better off finding out what other people might be doing in that space that works. Oh, there aren't other people in that space? Then run. Run away. Because there's a reason. If you find a market that has pain and nobody is serving that market, trust me, there's a reason. The reason more often than not is because they won't pay for it. And if they won't pay for it and you want to engage them, just understand that you're embarking on an act of futility when it comes to generating income or revenue. It's not going to happen. To describe in detail the profile of your ideal prospect is one that many people just don't take the time to do because it doesn't happen easily. It's not a process that just leaps to your mind and it's obvious. You got to dig and you kind of got to really think it through. And it's heavy mental lifting. For some, it's heavy emotional lifting. Where do we find these people? It can be even a more daunting task, especially for people that are not acclimated with some of the online tools and thinking about things like keyword research and so forth. There's plenty of resources online to help you with these things, and it's not as difficult. It is somewhat time-consuming. If you're going to do it well, it is time-consuming, but you just got to put in the time, put in the effort. And then to connect with people where they are is another thing that is also time-consuming. And you can think about social media and you can think, what a time waste. But it's not when you're connecting with people where they are. It's not when you are connecting with a purpose. It's not when you are out there with some drive and desire to find a group of people that have this pain, a pain that you feel completely confident that you can help eliminate, that you can help remedy, that you can help minimize, then you're seeking them out with a purpose, and you're going to interact with them with a purpose, and that is to give them value for free. Now, I'm not saying that all social media has to be that way. There are some people who do. I don't happen to feel that way. I happen to feel that social media can be such more of a broad and more of a life a life giving kind of a thing, and a life taking kind of a thing. Not in terms of murder, but in terms of gaining something from other people, people that you wouldn't be able to connect with otherwise, people that you would never in a million years meet in real life because of geography, because of demographic. And it's great. And I just think there's a bigger game here when it comes to social media than merely to use it for marketing. But I'm certainly in full agreement with some, Guy Kawasaki, for instance, and others, who think that social media is predominantly, if not strictly, a marketing tool. And I don't have any real problem with that. And then to think, what can I sell? What can I sell? What can I do for these people that they might be willing to pay me for? And of course, that, of course, goes on to speak to what price points, what kind of services can I offer that they might be willing to pay for? So just a little bit of a framework that might help you out with your online endeavors as you move forward. Till next time, Randy Cantrell. You can find me at the website at BulaNetwork.com. And until next time, I'll see you.